roach bong, and we're going to the Twisted Meat in Garden City at Rock of Ages. Fucking very historical hip hop place for fucking ICP to be and shit.
Have you been?
No.
I went and visited our friend Steven in Garden City, and he lives like two blocks away from Rock of Ages. I've seen the building. I've pulled into the parking lot, but Steven's like, "We're not going here, brother. We gotta go get some fucking Faygo Slurpees." I was like, "Damn!" We made it to America shortly after fucking, I don't know, 4 o'clock. And what happened, Rick?
Got pulled in, man.
What? Yeah? How did it go down?
What do you mean, how did it go down?
What happened?
Like, it just sucked. Really?
It just sucked. They just asked us a couple of questions, and then I started giving them answers, and I got a little wishy-washy for some reason, but then it ended up being, they took us into secondary.
Yeah.
And then they started asking me more questions, and I got more wishy-washy.
And me, it was just, you ever commit a crime?
No.
You ever do anything bad? No.
Yeah. No, not me. Major criminal here.
How do you know each other?
Oh God, it was just a bunch of stupid ass questions. They always ask little questions that you give answers to, and then they put the answer to that little question in a database, and then they keep a huge database on you. They keep asking me all these questions that whatever. I'm not gonna go on and on about it. But yeah, we got pulled into secondary. How long were we there? Almost an hour?
Yeah, about an hour.
We were there for about an hour, but now we're here. We have this dope ass truck, whoop whoop. Crazy fucking spooky house behind us. And a new person is going to be on the show probably in the next clip, so check that out.
A lot of soda pop.
This is the guy. You can't see his face yet. I don't think you can hear me talking, but that's him. He fucking lives... Well, I'm not going to tell you where he lives, but he watches the videos. And he fucking, he's like, "You want to go to this thing?" I'm like, "Yes, let's go." So he bought me a ticket, and fucking here we are. Hey, what up? I've been talking about you for like a minute. Nothing, where are we going? It's loud out here at these cars. Where are we going right now?
Rock of Ages, meet Twisted.
Twisted! We're here, it's like right across the street. You can't see through all these fucking stupid shits. I'm gonna win this whole box of shit.
I think so.
I need one of these frisbees actually. I've been looking for them for a while, so make sure you give me an easy question, okay?
I'll let you have a frisbee if you can get two of the five questions right.
Okay, let's do it. When do we start?
I'm getting the periscope set up right here.
Oh, we're gonna do a periscope?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, hey, what's up? It's James from Amateur 41 WRIF. Coming to you live from Rock of Ages in Garden City. It's Twisted. He's doing an
Twisted!
Store. Twisted's in the house today, right? Here's a bunch of Twisted, everybody.
Twisted!
Twisted!
All right, so Twisted is celebrating the re-release of their great album. They're doing a new store in Garden City at Rock of Ages. They're here till 8 o'clock signing autographs. You can meet them. While I'm here, I'm playing a little game I like to call Are You Smarter Than a Juggalo? So I have five trivia questions I'm going to ask. They're all based around elementary school knowledge. If you, each question you answer correctly, I'm going to give you some sort of prize, starting with the name of Chuck the Ring sticker, going all the way up to a very limited autographed Twisted item. So I have a first contestant. What's your name? Where are you from?
notslim1, Windsor, Ontario.
I have no idea what you just said, but okay. notslim1, is
that's
that what
right.
You said? Okay, so we got notslim1 all the way from Windsor, Ontario as our first contestant. So you know the rules. You got five questions. First to fifth grade, you have to answer them correctly. Each one you get right, you're going to get some sort of prize. Are you ready for your first question?
Hell yeah, let's do it.
Okay, first question. True or false? Most people in Spain speak Spanish. Is that true or false?
I'm going to say true.
Correct. So he's got himself a damn chicken brick sticker right so far. So far. I don't know why I said so far twice. That was kind of weird. Next question. Second grade. Second grade science. You're any good at science?
I don't have a t-shirt.
What was the question? That's not the question. This is just me asking. Are you good at science? No? Okay. Does a meteorologist study meteors, oceans, or the weather?
The weather, Alex.
The weather. Yeah. Got two questions correct.
Look at that Canadian. He's smart.
Yeah, the Canadian education system might be a little bit better than ours in the States, huh?
Well, yeah.
So again, make a candidate for you. This is for grade three. This is a grade three geography question.
Okay, I suck at geography.
Now the Amazon River is located on what continent? Which continent is the Amazon River located on? You don't know, you can try to think it out.
What continent is the Amazon River on? Do you get any like help from the audience?
Oh, yeah. No help from the audience. What are you thinking? What are you thinking? What's your mind? Okay, thank you for giving me the answer.
I didn't hear the answer though. I honestly didn't hear the answer. Can we still try?
Sure.
I really didn't hear.
What do you think?
I don't think that Egypt is a continent.
That's correct. Egypt is not a continent.
I don't know what continent is. Egypt, right?
Well, the Nile would be a river, I guess.
In Egypt?
It might be in Egypt, but we're looking for the Amazon.
Okay.
Well, we're looking for the Amazon river again.
Oh, I thought you said the Nile River.
No, you keep saying the Nile.
Are you messing with me right now?
You keep saying the Nile. It's the Amazon River.
What continent?
The Nile!
What continent is Amazon?
What continent is the Amazon located? Well, that's the question I'm asking you.
You know, I really will give an answer, but I don't know. I guess the Amazon. South America.
You totally heard the answer.
No, I swear I didn't. I swear I did.
Why would I play this game? He's got three questions right. Because you're totally trying to play me.
No, I'm not. Don't say the answer.
No help from the crowd. No help from the crowd. Come on. Okay, grade four English. You ready for this question?
All right. English? Okay.
Yeah. Who was Detective Sherlock Holmes' assistant?
Watson.
What does he have the title before Watson? What was he?
Actually.
Elementary. No, that's not my answer.
It's like a profession. What profession would he go by?
Was he a doctor?
Correct. Dr. Watson. Four questions correct.
You're killing this. This is a great contest.
Okay. What a one rip.
Thank you. All right, final question.
Okay.
True or false? This is a fifth grade English question.
Okay.
Boom, pow, whoosh are all examples of an onomatopoeia. Is that true or false?
It's true, because onomatopoeias are words that are sounds, right?
Give me another example of onomatopoeia.
Which three did you say?
I said boom, pow, and whoosh. Bang! Perfect. Whoop, whoop,
whoop, whoop, that's the rip of shit.
You put a whole lot of juice and stuff here. So
all right.
Whoop, whoop.
Yeah, we're going to do the sign, the meet and greet now, and then we're going to go to Detroit to the shelter for the concert. It's going to be off the chain. Are you guys going to show up and hand out more stuff?
Possible. Hey, got a twisted frisbee for you. I got a twisted frisbee. Whoop, and a woozy. We're going to get tickets to tonight's official party.
All right. Nice. Sweet. Thanks.
Walk away with these, and I'm going to let them pick out a fancy autograph thing. If you want to go check out the party tonight at the shelter, doors open up at 10. Tickets are $10.
So this one?
Yeah.
Right? Is another shirt with something else on the back of it.
Okay.
But they threw it on the back
of it. So what's the front and what's the back?
This is the front of it.
That's dope.
Yeah, that is cool.
And then that's the back.
That's the only part that I saw was the back part. I didn't realize that.
I
bought the event shirt, because fuck it. Check it out. It's got some shit on the back. I'll show it later.
Yeah, it's pretty sweet.
Uh-huh. You just buy all of them, bro. You're crazy.
This one says the green book on the back of it.
Nice. This one talks about the tour. And then this guy rolled up in like a fucking crazy rape van and started throwing 2 liters out. That's the back of the shirt I got. This guy started throwing 2 liters, so I ran up and I got one. And then the riff came up and did a fucking contest, and I won 2 tickets to the show tonight, a beer koozie, a Dave and Chuck the Freak sticker for the riff, that's the radio station, and this glow-in-the-dark frisbee. It is glow-in-the-dark frisbee. I'm going to get this signed today. And then I also got this number 170 of 750 limited print of an original hand-drawn Jamie but it's a copy, though. It's a print. It's a print. He didn't hand draw this. It is a print.
Yeah, but still, it looks like he only printed out.
And are you going to give me one of these?
Yes.
Dope. Thanks. I fucking love that. Sweet. So now we got all our merch sorted, so I think it's time to head back to Rock of Ages now.
I don't buy it for now.
I wonder if you can get a car.
out of that hat mess.
Just left Rock of Ages. I'm leaving it right now. Look, the car is in motion, and I got this signed by Jimmy Madrox and Monoxide Child. It was cool. I told them they looked really sweaty. And he's like, yeah, it's hot in here. It was cool. I'm driving right now to this fucking venue, the shelter in Detroit, and I'm not sure where I'm at, what road I'm on. Do you know what road we're on?
We are on Ford.
We're on Ford Road headed to Detroit, and these chicks just rolled up and they're like, not Slim One! And they're like driving on the highway right here where we're fucking driving right now. And they're like, not Slim One! And I'm like, yeah, I threw up the Wicked Clown sign. And they're like, are you not Slim One? I'm like, yeah. They're like, keep it up, I love your vlogs. And then she rolled up her window and sped off. She could have been the one, man. Hey?
That was sweet.
Really fucking super fucking crazy. I've been recognized in public before, mostly at Juggalo events. Never like that on the road. But I gotta turn right right now.
Short and to the point as I can be, but I want to explain this thing that is the Green Book to y'all, so you can wrap your mind
why
around it.
Why such a big deal to us?
Why it ain't right? Why? Because I've been listening. This is real shit. I've been answering tweets and he's Snapchatting motherfuckers and everybody keeps saying why do y'all? I mean, hey, whoop the social media. Goddamn it! I kind of see I blanked at them all in one shit. No, but seriously, like people like why y'all keep re-releasing shit. Okay, let me tell you something. Listen. Okay, listen, I'm gonna break it down for you real quick. These albums are like our children, and we are collectively getting custody to our kids. You know what I'm saying? We're bringing them home. Those are our babies. So we're proud to re-release our shit through us. So you can get it how we intended it to be, how we will do forever. And come on, vinyl, dog? Are we kidding? Vinyl? Hey. I ain't patting myself on the back, I'm patting my team on the back. M&E, dog, they school that shit. I'm just, look at that. Everything is changing, the colors are green. Pumpkins rotting away like souls. I did it. See how they did that?
I didn't know what you were doing.
That's what happens when he smoked weed with me. I'll be in a whole nother realm. But listen, 2003, and I might be off on my facts.
You're right.
Thank you. 2003, the motherfucker come out. And then it do well, and then over time, it becomes harder and harder to find and harder to get a hold of. And like, even, and I'm not a digital motherfucker. I'm Fred Flintstone, that's George Jetson. I am like, I still send letters in the mail. I'm that guy. When you get that creepy fucking ransom letter from Jamie Madrox, you're like, I've officially reached stalker status.
But he still jacks off the magazine.
I do, for real, for real. Hey man, magazines are important. You gotta keep publications in sync. But what I'm saying is...
We better wrap it up.
Really? No. Listen. So the album becomes more and more harder to find over time. And new levels of shit like iTunes and lime, what is it, LimeWire, Green, what's the other motherfucker? It's a couple of them.
There's a couple.
There's like a Pandora or some shit. You can never get the Green Book. You can never get it. People ask, why, motherfucker, why? I don't know. But now you will be able to, so that's what I'm trying to say. And there's two versions, collective versions, man, out there remastered, and I just can't say it enough. Green vinyl. I'm not gonna talk your ear off. I'm not gonna spoil the night. I came to drink and smoke and watch my homies perform, and I would like to continue that if it's cool. I said what I want to say. I might come back and talk some more shit to y'all. I don't know. Is it cool if I do that? Is it cool if I bring monoxide? Should he get me more high? Should I get him drunk? He's like, oh, hell no, we all going to jail. But look, hey. Make some motherfucking noise for our motherfucking homeboy, Ajax in the house!
Yeah, yeah, yeah! You met a fucking artist, and
right.
When he introduces himself, he's like, yeah, my name's MC Bubblicious Fish Eyes, or whatever the
yes.
fuck the case.
Dude, Bubblicious Fish Eyes right. has a dope-ass single out.
Exactly.
It's called Keep On Poppin'.
He was one of the few people that wasn't like that.
Right.
Like, it just felt genuine. And so we took him on tour, mm-hmm. and we hung out with him just to really see what he was like.
No, he likes horror movies, too. and that's my shit. So we click on that level, like we trade movies. He's probably one of the only, he's probably one of five people in this room who really and truly knows who Rawhead Rex is. Look, there's a hush fell over the crowd.
I wasn't even there.
See? See? I'm telling you. Go home tonight when you go home. Google Rawhead Rex. Get a little clap marker. You knew it? You knew it? There's three. Me, Prozac, and this guy. I'm telling you. See, he's on that level. He knows that shit. We have...
Is
we,
it like two chicks, one cup?
No. No, but what I'm saying is when he's on tour, sometimes we have late night seances and shit. Prozac be knowing shit. And then when you get him high, when you be on that...
His conspiracy theories?
He has conspiracy theories that will blow the minds of anyone, anywhere.
I feel like I've talked Prozac off the ledge a couple times.
I'm saying, right,
but
right.
We're like, we're going to go down there. We're going to storm the
we're
doors.
Like, hold on. You can't do that. You can't do that.
You absolutely can't.
It's 2016. As soon as you step out your door, they're filming you.
You're right.
And he's like, see, and that's what I'm saying. You ever notice how you got this bump behind the back of your ears and you start rubbing that shit and you start going home, be like, oh, bitch.
Keep touching it.
I got that bump. What is that? Did they tag me? Am I tagged? You better everybody tonight gonna go home tonight when they tag done taking a piss. Well, that was a good show. Hey, bitch, come here. Look, do I got a tag? I'm saying, don't get tagged, for real. Look.
But,
hey, man. It's some strange shit happening out there.
There's a lot of people that I talked to that I didn't talk off the ledge.
It's true.
He's one of the people that I did.
But he is. And what I want you to do right now is make the motherfucking most noise that you possibly can right now. And motherfucking welcome my homeboy, the one, the only, Prozac to the stage!
Check. Hey, yo, fam. I know it's a magic night tonight.
Check.
But are you motherfuckers ready to get stretched? Almost convinced. Are you ready to get strange?
During this crucial time of transition, we have...
Can I get a Prozac? Prozac! Prozac! Prozac!
What's up, Detroit? Just a little bit, make some noise.
I only signed up for this deal to my family to get some help. I said that they will pay the bill. Do to this stage, I don't know if it'll be legal for us to come back on it, but we've known them forever. We've been friends with them since back before we were even born. I don't know how that works out, but it's the brotherhood of the hand.
Right, well, they were gardeners and we were flowers in a former life.
Exactly. He was like a garden gnome and R.O.C. was a butterfly or fucking, I don't know, maybe Blaze was a woodchuck. I picture myself a chubby squirrel. I don't know why, I just do. I don't care if you like it, fuck off. I picture myself a motherfucking squirrel. I'll be the thuggest motherfucking squirrel you ever seen. Like, man, I hate squirrels, especially that fat motherfucker right there. I'll be on the porch like,
play a song.
Fuck you. Listen, so these two motherfuckers, ROC and Blaze, we've known them forever. They came to us on a bus, a tour bus, eons ago. And they're like, we want to do this band. We want to do this side project. We want to do this thing called Zodiac Imprint. And I'm just like, okay, great. That sounds amazing. Time lapses. I'm horrible with time. You know what I'm saying? But time lapses. Then out of nowhere, they're like, listen to this. That's pretty fucking cool. Time lapses. These motherfuckers got two
motherfucking albums out, a hit video. They're joining us on our tour coming up. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for the motherfucking R.O.C. And place your dead homie. The one and only Zodiac imprint in the house. I'm gonna need you to turn the lights real low. I don't want nobody to see this shit until it's ready to be seen. Woo-hoo!
Zodiac goes has a price to pay. Needs Aphrodite and Asher, rightly skeptical weapon, tactical method, stepping when he has it for slice of life. My evil presence got you second guessing, I feel it right. But it's enticing, I'm nice and stronger than a bison. But I'm gonna be the colder than a culture older than
show me your butthole!
So where we're at right now is the shelter. It's the underground club underneath St. Andrew's Hall. And this stage right here is apparently the stage that Eminem did his movie 8 Mile on and shit, from all the real battle rappers. So anyway, that's it.
I'd rather do this than go on.
That's it. I turned the camera on and started farting, and I didn't stop farting until the camera said 4 seconds. How was that, Zodiac imprint?
That was fucking dope, man.
Yeah?
I can't wait to see them on tour.
Are we going to hit a month?
Are we going to hit up the tour in a month?
They said they're coming back to the shelter, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, they did.
Did you love it?
Yeah, it was a good time.
Did you like hanging out with me and fucking Rick all day?
Yeah. It was good to finally meet you guys.
Yeah? So we're going to fucking be friends now and do more stuff together?
You got it.
You're in the vlog, buddy. This is you in the vlog right now. You're going to watch this at your house.
Yep, I will be too.
And be like, oh my God, I hung out with him. It was so crazy.
Oh man, finally.
Hey, let's go make sure the truck isn't broken into instead of hanging out in this alley like a fucking couple of idiots.
That's what I was wondering too. Got me curious.
The guys are right in front of me smoking a couple cigarettes before they get in the truck, but I just wanted to say, excuse me, whatever. So as I was walking out of the club, this fucking chick was like, hey, I know you, you're a Canada guy. And I was like, yeah, I am. And then I kind of walked away because it was kind of weird. But every time I come to the States, I got recognized twice tonight. I couldn't fucking, that shit is dope. Oh, the truck's been making this weird chugging sound. And I know I've talked about it before, and it's like getting worse. I need money to fix the truck. I need money for everything, but I need money to fix the truck. Anyway, it's 1:48 in the morning right now. We're right here at St. Andrew's Hall. We're right at this time. This, I think, is the bridge, if it's not the tunnel. And that's it. We're going to double back a little bit. We got to go fucking drop Jordan off at his point of interest, at his recent destination, which is Grand River Avenue. It's the Motor City. Hear that? Fucking don't stop. Anyway, we gotta go to the Motor City Casino parking garage.
Turn right and then immediately turn left.
We're only like 5 or 7 minutes away, so we're gonna go drop him off and then we're gonna double back and go home. Ready? I'm out here in the ghetto. I shouldn't yell too loud in the ghetto, eh? Look at this boarded up house and shit. Shit's crazy. And then like right across the street, giant fucking casino.
Yeah. Like, ghetto casino.
Yeah, ghetto casino, exactly.
How quick it can change. That's nuts.
Well, what's up? I don't know how to act with you on the vlog because we just met. But now we're just not meeting. We're leaving each other now. This is the end right now.
And it went by quick.
A couple of smokes.
Yeah, went by quick. I had a good time. It was nice to...
Yeah, it was really fun to meet you.
Me too. It was a ton of fun.
And you, Roach.
Yeah, I had a good time.
Fucking HALLOWICKED next.
Food, yeah. That won't be very far.
Oh, yeah. We went to Stevens and we had good chicken wings and pizza from Slice of the 80s.
Oh, my God. I don't even remember that. Like, I remember tasting the food. I remember that pizza. That pizza.
You remember me fucking calling you out for falling asleep while eating?
With the piece of pizza in my hand?
Yeah, and the fucking chicken wings sliding off the plate.
It was so close, and then he caught it. We both kind of looked at it at the same time, but he called it out first. It was funny. Oh, it was perfect timing, too.
It's like, watch out, sleepy.
Yep.
What time did you work yesterday?
I started at 11:30.
You worked at 11:30 p.m. on Thursday night?
I awoke at 3:10 on Thursday.
You got up at 3:10 p.m. on Thursday?
Yeah.
And it's now pretty much 3 a.m. on
Saturday.
Friday. Saturday morning, Friday night, 3 a.m.
Yeah, Friday night.
So that's 36 hours.
Roughly,
but
yeah.
You did get a couple of naps.
Yeah, I did.
But not enough for 36 hours of being awake, though.
Yeah. I don't know.
Zodiac imprint?
Hell yeah, man. It was a dope show.
Yeah?
Fuck yeah.
It was good. I liked it. They played a couple tracks that I knew. I'm glad I listened to that Zodiac imprint CD one time.
Well, they played all the old Zodiac songs too.
Yeah, yeah. I recognize like two or three of them.
Yeah.
Was one of them a Blaze song?
I believe so. Yeah.
I think he did too, but I can't remember which
one
it was.
I think he did a couple Blaze songs with
ROC. I can't remember which one it was.
I recognize one. I don't even know the name of it, but they had.
They're just fake ass Juggalos.
The MNE sampler that they gave out at Juggalo Day. I recognize one from up there.
They kept playing that fucking trap album.
Yeah. I was thinking that they would come out and at least do one song. But it is what it is. I mean, I understand.
No, no. When they're hosting, they're not going to do a song.
I figured they did a Twistmas.
Did they?
Yeah. But
did I go to Twistmas?
Yeah, we went to Twistmas.
Which one was that one?
Last Twistmas.
What happened? Yeah, that was a dope, awesome show, right?
Yeah, because fucking... Triple Threat that day.
And then Ballers was like weak compared to it, right?
Oh, yeah, that's what.
And it was at the
me.
Same place,
you
wasn't it?
Me. Yeah, that's what you told me.
That's the one that I have. They were both at the Crowfoot, right? Where I have that poster with Twistmas and Big Ballers listed on it.
Yeah.
Yeah, Twistmas. That Twistmas I remember was way better than the Ballers.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm just surprised. I guess that for the it being the release of the Green album that. I just figured they would have even maybe wanted to have done one
song.
They would have
come out and said goodbye.
Or said bye, that too.
I heard that they jet as soon as they introed fucking imprint.
Well, was it just me or did Monoxide seem not himself today? He just seemed out of it.
He was really quiet, eh?
Yeah, he didn't say much.
He did not say much.
At all, even at the meet and greet, he just seemed like something was bugging him.
Yeah, that's true too. He was very quiet at the meet and greet. Yeah, I thought that, but I never said anything out loud. Yeah, I agree.
Jamie did all the talking and everything today.
Listen. Fuck those guys right now. It's a 4-minute vlog clip. My arm is fucking getting sore. We're going to hang out a little more, but it was nice to meet you. And we're going to do HALLOWICKED at least.
Yeah.
And then something else maybe after that.
We'll figure something out.
Dope. All right. Whoop, whoop.
Whoop, whoop.
Whoop, whoop.
Nice.
I like this shot. I like shooting on the bridge. We're vlogging right now.
Yeah.
I like this. It's always a nice little...
What, it's 2:40 a.m.
Yeah.
On the bridge.
Look at this. Traffic looks backed up.
Yeah, it does, actually.
So, should I pass here?
I don't think so.
We'll see what happens over the apex. It is moving. This is the slowest I've moved on the bridge. You ever see those videos? Remember that fucking news thing a little while ago about the guy who, whose camper caught on fire coming back into Canada?
Really?
His fucking buddy had this nice 3-axle huge fucking camper. And it just fucking burst into flames on the bridge. Big, huge black smoke coming off the bridge. That must have been, I guess, I remember the weather was nice. So it was probably the summer of 2015.
Really?
Maybe. I think so. But yeah, I remember seeing the footage on the news and how crazy all that was. I want to pass these guys, but...
I don't think you're allowed to do that on the bridge, are you?
Well, is this not a lane right here?
I don't think so.
Are you sure?
No.
It's gotta be a fucking lane. I wanna fucking... I'm not gonna do it, because you got me all fucking... worried about it.
I don't know.
It just looks like smooth sailing.
Dude, we don't see anybody else using it.
It looks like just a bunch of fucking semis in front of us, really.
See all these fancy lights? That's all Canada right there. There's the McDonald's. I fucking hate that coming off the bridge you see a McDonald's.
Why?
I don't know. It's like real corporate or something. See? Okay, doing it.
It's a semi lane.
Yeah, yeah. That's it, right? It's a big truck lane. Bridge sometimes freaks me out.
Yeah. It's 2 a.m. Where are all these trucks coming from?
You got a time to make the donuts, Rick. Oh, geez, Rick. Well, I guess it's time to make the donuts. Oh, my God. I'm so glad I decided to fucking follow this lane. We would have been there for hours. Look at all these trucks we're fucking passing. Jesus. Oh, we did it.
Made it.
All right, here's hoping I don't fucking get detained for owing money in Quebec. Now that we're back home in Canada. All right, there's a lot of vehicles, and so I'm just going to turn this off now. Oh, I guess there's not, but we are at the thing anyway here, so. Boom. You going to my place tonight, bud?
Mm-hmm.
Alright, let's go. You tired?
A little bit.
Alright, let's
go. It's just from sitting. Like,
we're going to another party. Ready?
Yeah. I'm out of smokes, but yeah.
Good. Smoking's bad. Quit smoking. You missed a good show tonight.
I missed a really good show, Zodiac.
It was really good. It was really good. I was saying to him earlier in the States that
I'm pretty sad.
I think they did at least one Blaze song. I think I recorded a Blaze song. I don't feel bad that I don't know. But I think it was.
They only have an EP, so I'm sure they had time to fill, so they probably played some other stuff.
What else is up? What did you do tonight? Just drink fucking labelless beers?
Yep.
We came home and I told him, I'm like, listen, we gotta go drive uptown real quick. And I creeped by here and I saw some light peering out of the bottom of the garage.
The garage is open.
Yeah.
3 feet. Shut down now.
And I was like, fuck yeah.
We got one suspicious character, we had to close it.
Yeah, I couldn't. That was real shit when I had to have Rick push my body down. I couldn't compact my gut. It's too.
It wasn't limbo height. It was crawl height.
Yeah. Well, I guess I learned today that I can't crawl.
Or limbo.
It's Saturday, I guess, at fucking 4:30 in the fucking morning. Roach Bong's awake again. He's eating. How's the food, bud?
It's Mickey D's, man. It's breakfast.
Which is better than most Mickey D's.
We went to that place where we shot the clip of Roach Bong sleeping again, and my friend there gave me this bottle of like concentrated patchouli, and I was like squeezing it and smelling it. Now I have like patchouli embedded in my fucking nose. All I smell is patchouli.
Really?
Patchouli. Anyway, the wind's blowing, so we're going to bed. You ready?
Yeah.
All right. I'm too lazy to take the camera off the tripod to vlog you, but here you are. This is a completely different show.
This is
the real life show. It's happening now. You're
this
here.
This is behind the scenes.
Yeah. We just finished shooting Positive Vibes then behind the scenes. I got the camera on the tripod still. What were we watching? Oh, some fucking Why Would You Do That videos?
Why Would You Do That, man? Yeah. You had to gather.
So what do you think then? You think you could handle fucking Carolina Reaper fermented bean curd challenge?
I know I can do a Reaper, no problem. Bean curd, I don't think so.
It stinks. It's like an open suit. Describe it.
Oh, it's nasty. It's like it's worse than
stink.
No, it's like open sewer, like shit stink.
It's like if a baby like had a diarrhea dump with. And you wrap that diaper say, up and
like
put
baby
it.
Baby shit. Or
that's
like
what you have to deal
shit.
With.
Out in the sun.
Out in the
a
sun.
A rotten one out in the sun.
Yeah.
And then, in an attempt to preserve it, put a bunch of rock salt in it. Put that in your mouth. And then swallow it also, though.
I'll do it one day for the show.
Yeah!
Have I ever steered you wrong?
No!
That's it.
Well, that's all the vlog with you for today, then. I got a big fucking concert vlog yesterday from that fucking Michigan shit. It was awesome.
Yeah.
Stop being a criminal so that we can go to the States together.
I'm not a criminal.
Can we go to the States?
I can go to the States.
Really?
Yeah.
All right, let's do it.
I just gotta get my passport first.
Do that!
You know what? Fuck it. The contest, man.
Oh, yeah.
The contest. It's happening. It's happening in September.
Yeah.
You gotta watch.
Yeah.
You know, watch out for them fucking, mystical, magical, fucking wonderful, hidden, secretive words, you know?
Yeah.
And, like, you'll win fucking talking to... Two tickets to HALLOWICKED.
You held up Detroit. Four fingers.
Oh, I did too, eh? Two tickets.
Yeah, man, we're going to do a fucking contest to give away two HALLOWICKED tickets. We already got one. Where is it?
Yeah.
I think it's under this empty donut box, boy.
Yeah,
there it is. Oh, yeah. So you could win this HALLOWICKED ticket and another and probably a bunch of other stuff.
Other cool fucking shit.
More details will follow in the next couple of weeks.
Yeah.
But this is going down. This and another one could be you, for you and a friend.
Remember, subscribe.
Well, not for you. We're going to get our tickets. We're going to get ours.
Subscribe. Look for those fucking mystical, magical, secretive words.
That's so many words. That's so many words to describe words.
But that's it, man. That's the hype. It's,
thanks for doing that, because I would have forgot to do it tomorrow.
I know. But I'm so hyped about it, because I'm like, I can't wait for somebody to win.
I know. I really hope that we get a fucking awesome contest here. I don't know how this works. I hope we get an awesome contest.
Fuck yeah.
Popping off. It's going to happen all month. And it's going to be awesome.
Man. We might meet somebody who watches the show religiously and... Freaking, you know.
Bro, what if it was that girl that was hollering at me that won the tickets? I'd be like, what? Are you fucking kidding me?
Oh, man.
It will worldwide, everybody can get the ticket.
Yeah.
Not like some contests that only ship within their own country.
Yeah, world fucking wide.
Worldwide. I don't know. Make two W's.
Worldwide.
Yeah! Yeah! Alright, that's it. I gotta fucking drive this guy home now. Whoop, whoop.
Whoop, whoop.